Hey, YouTube friends and family, I'm back. I gotta tell you something. I wanna cry. I do. Not tears of unhappiness, but of joy. My last video, as I go through the high number of comments, and I see the unity, I see the sharing forward of great ideas, irregardless of the SNAP and the EBT and what's happening with them. What I'm seeing is where people are coming together with great ideas. Super, super helping ideas. Great recipes. And this is what we need. There is so many, many things we can learn from one another. So many. We cannot bank on our government to be taking care of our world in any way, shape, or form. We cannot. We certainly cannot. And we have for too long. And in many ways, it has hurt us. This little run, this little sample of the EBT and SNAP program being shut down in 17 states on the 12th of October, and then the warning that came out that in November there would be none, should have us all awake, but not feeling despair, not even a little bit. Because I have you, and you have me. And that isn't all. I'm putting up a video attached to this. Many of you are familiar with Ben Time Traveler, Ben Matthews. If you're not, you should be. You most certainly should be. And he put out a video today that I say, bravo. We need more like this. We need people sharing their knowledge and their wisdom. We have people out here, all the preppers, that get on here day after day, or as often as they can, and they share the secrets of their prepping. They share recipes. They share canning. They share walks in the woods and the forest, how to build shelters, how to get safe, how to protect yourselves, how to eat in the woods, how to dig for roots and mushrooms, etc., etc., etc. I see so many repeats of newsreels in our videos. I see Comet Ison warnings day after day after day in our videos. And granted, those are important. Don't get me wrong. But right now, friends, with 14 days left before the 1st of November, and until people actually have that EBT card and it works, or that SNAP card and it works, I wouldn't trust that on November 1st, that things are going to work. Don't put your faith in an unstable foundation, a foundation that has cracks everywhere. And let us not forget this grand speech from our president was nothing more than a band-aid over a terrible, terrible wound that may yet fester. So take time to evaluate your own situation. Do the inventory on what you have. Click into videos that will help you can. Teach you how to can. Many jars that you throw away can be reused. Believe me, I do it all the time. Save what you can save. Learn what you can learn. Store up what you can store up. Share information. We even have people telling us how to make homemade soap. go through these comments on my last video, guys. They rock. What a wonderful, wonderful community we have. And I love each and every one of you. I'm going to get off of here, already used up 5 minutes. And the video that's following this, listen to it. All of the information you need will be down in the show more to click. Go and check out his channel and subscribe, because he's got information that we need. We certainly do. Put your faith in each other, not in the government, not in their plastic card, not in their automatic deposits. We better not put our faith there. The foundation is crumbling. But you know what, friends, family? Let us not forget. We, the people, built this country. We, the people. They did not. Think about that. Love you all, and I will catch you guys later. Enjoy Ben Time Traveler as he shares great wisdom. Great big hugs.
Top of the morning to you, top of the night, whatever the case may be. My name's Ben Matthews. I am who I say I am. Your world government ain't trust me on that. I know these things. You know, some people say they like to hear me talk. I don't know why. I don't know if I'm making any difference, to tell you the truth. I really don't. For instance, I'll make this video. I don't know if it'll help anything. I just know that what I know about the future, a lot of people should take to heart this video. Because, you know, one of these days, not too far off here, you ain't going to be able to go to the grocery store and buy some fruits and vegetables. Okay? There won't be none there for you to buy. You won't be able to buy no peanut butter and jelly for your kids or your grandchildren. But if you know how to jar and can these things, you're going to be all right. You can make your own grape jelly. You can make your own peanut butter. I like putting honey in mine, to tell you the truth. It's just something that I enjoy. You can take tomatoes and make a tomato sauce. It's garlic, oregano, rosemary, thyme, some chives, some mushrooms, some onions, some green peppers, red, orange, yellow peppers. You can make yourself a nice tomato sauce. Oh, and you could take that tomato sauce and create so many different meals out of it, okay? Let me tell you. For instance, you could take some rice. You can have some Spanish rice tonight. You could take some elbow noodles and make some Hungarian goulash. Spaghetti noodles. You can have some spaghetti sauce tonight. So many things. Not counting the juices. Grape juice, apple juice, carrot juice, pineapple juice, all the juices mixed together, bananas, all the vegetables and fruits all mixed together to make juices. Stewed tomatoes, all potatoes are endless. Potatoes are endless. All this and so many other things that you can learn to do. Dehydrating food, fish, meats, fruits. All that you can learn. See, because they keep that away. Generation after generation, they keep the knowledge to themselves. They take it away from your children and your grandchildren. This is something that your children and grandchildren won't know. How to, simple thing like how to jar and can fruits and vegetables, or meats, eggs, all that. They won't know. No. It's at that point in time, even at this generation, just simply to walk to the freezer, open it up, and grab a TV dinner and stick it in the microwave. That's the extent of cooking in America anymore. That's how people cook. Want some fried chicken tonight? Grab the banquet, throw it in the oven. And it's not their fault. It's by design. They do this by design to keep you ignorant, keep you dumbed down. But if you go online and learn these things, how to can and jar fruits and vegetables, and then go buy these supplies and try it yourself, learn it, learn the process, stock your pantries, stock your shelves with some homemade grape jellies and peanut butters and apple sauces, tomato sauces. It's just endless what you can do. Then you won't be one of them people that go to the grocery store and sit there and say, there's no food. You'll be all right. You'll be able to feed your children, your husband, your wife, your mother, your father, brother, sister, whoever. You'll be able to feed them. And then you'll have so many options and different meals that you create with these things and the rice and the noodles and the beans. Stew some tomatoes, some beans. Man, it's endless of the meal you can create. You just gotta wake up again. That's all. Which brings me to something that I'd like to discuss about this Halloween coming up. You know, when you go carve out them pumpkins this year with your kids or grandchildren, and you make yourself a jack-o'-lantern, and you stick that candle in there, I want you to remember something, okay? When you're cleaning out the inside of them guts, and all them seeds are in there, and you're throwing all that away, and wasting it, throwing it in the garbage, just think of two things. Pumpkin pie. I know, pumpkin pie can be hard to make. Just think about it. Another thing I want you to think about, one of my favorite snacks, pumpkin seeds. So when you're throwing all them away because you don't think they got any value, remember, a little bit of sea salt, you got yourself a good snack. You just got to learn how to do it. It's quite easy to clean up them seeds. Some people like to soak them in sea salt and then put them in the oven. There's different methods. It's quite easy to do. And like I said, it's one of my favorite snacks. A little bit of sea salt. Peace and love be that of God and God's army, because you are an army to fear, and so is the truth. They want you to forget the past. They want you to forget all these simple things that you should not forget. Because they want you to be dependent on them. Gotta depend on them. For the food, your water, your heat, everything. Well, you don't have to be. Just wake up and look at the seeds of truth.